Basically, he said that sometimes we are put in situations and we are put in positions, and it is for our betterment, and it is for our growth ultimately. So I sat here and I listened to him, and I thought about when we went to the women's conference. I had just joined the praise and worship team, and I think I've been here 2 weeks. And it was my first lead, and when I joined, I told Sister Annie, and I told my Sister June, I'm not singing no lead. And I ended up singing lead. I volunteered. I guess it was the Holy Spirit, but I volunteered to sing lead.
Amen.
And then Mom, in her infinite wisdom, decided we were going to this women's conference, and she wanted us to sing, and I said, oh yeah, I'll do it, I'll do it. She didn't tell us it was 350 women. And we ended up singing in front of about 250 of the 350. And I've probably shared this story before with some of you, but have you ever watched like the award show and you see Beyonce tear it up and you go, ooh, who's gonna follow after her? I hate for the person to follow after her. Well, at the women's conference, we sang after Yolanda Adams and Beyonce and Mary Mary and Haley Jackson. So it was tough. And what I got from that is Mom told us we were being stretched.
Yes.
So anyway, when I listened to Pastor's sermon, I thought about that experience, and my brother Horace said we were the Bad News Bears of the women's conference, but he said that in love. But one thing about that experience, I will say, that even though we followed after some amazing talent, and they had bands and drums, and I will say that we brought them to the altar.
Amen.
I do not remember, maybe it's my memory, but I do not remember so many people being up at the altar to the point where I had to back up because they were at the altar.
Yes.
So we may not have had the talent, but we had the anointing.
Amen.
Amen.
And we had the heart.
Amen.
So
I thank you for that. But I remembered all of that and I said, okay, you're being stretched, Monica. So, sometimes I started yapping, and that's what I do. I talk. When I was asked to deliver, I thought about Russell, and Russell is the minister, he's the preacher, but in real life, he's quiet. We had Tristan's birthday party, and we played this game where you couldn't say Tristan, baby, or the number one, and Russell won because he doesn't say anything. But in church, we can't get him to be quiet. So, but again, that's the anointing. It's not him, it's the anointing. And then I was singing over there before I forget. Russell shared his story about his medical issue. And for those of you that saw me over there bawling, it is because when Russell was diagnosed with cancer, he didn't want to tell his family. He didn't want me to tell his family. And I said, baby, you can't do that. For two reasons. Well, number one, we need prayer. And number two, if something happens to you, you'll be mad at me.
That's right.
You gotta open your mouth and tell him. And he did. And I think he didn't want to tell him because he didn't want to accept it. And I hear the foot, baby, and I love you too. So for him to stand up here and to tell his story, and he didn't even want to tell his own family, I thank God for that.
Amen.
So hopefully his story will help somebody else. And thank you for being transparent, sweetheart. Thank you. And now he's bawling like a baby, like I was over there.
That's all right.
Amen.
There's a tissue underneath there. But anyway, sometimes as Christians, we're being stretched, and it's needed. And I think about the analogy of you purchasing shoes, like these shoes are new, and I'm on some medication. I'm not supposed to probably be wearing shoes for my knee. But once they're stretched, the shoes are stretched, they are completely serviceable. So as Christians, once we're stretched, we become serviceable, completely serviceable for his use. So remember that when you're being stretched, because that's what I'm getting. Back to the story again. I'm kind of going in and out, but again, I'm a talker. I'm not a minister, so I'm just going. We're going to talk about the word. We're share the word. But after the awesome message that Pastor Wendell gave, I prayed and I went to bed, and I woke up and I sent this pitiful message apologizing and thanking him for stretching me. And when I went to sleep, I woke up singing. I had this awesome dream, and I woke up singing, Great is Thy Faithfulness. And so that is the title of the message. It's Great is Thy Faithfulness. So then I started looking up faithfulness and what the Bible says about faithfulness. And in Psalm 36:5, and they're going to put it up so you don't have to pull out your Bibles. It says, Our steadfast love, O Lord, extends to the heavens, your faithfulness to the clouds. That is a lot of faithfulness. That is a lot of faithfulness. And I would venture to say that that is unlimited faithfulness. And then I started thinking about unlimited faithfulness and started thinking about how it manifests itself. And I thought about in the his unlimited faithfulness, we get grace, we receive gifts, and we receive his goodness. And his grace is what saves and secures us.
Amen.
His gifts are so compassionate. And his gifts are a lot of times in the form of his presence, his performance, his provision, and his person. So when you think about his gifts, think about those things. And his goodness satisfies and sustains us. And it also saves us. And so that's a lot of information, and I was trying to think about how I can convey this, what I wanted to say to Serena and Lindsay and Joshua and Laura and Tyler and Patricia and all the other children here, Janae and Janaya and Tristan. And I feel like mom for mom right now, but I wanted to think about how to convey that or how to get them to remember that. And I thought about a quarter, a coin. And there are two sides of a coin. And I had a coin here, but everybody knows what a coin looks like. And there are two sides. And at a football game, you toss a coin, or somebody, who was the baby that tosses the coin? The referee or somebody. I'm a huge football fan, as you can see. But yeah, somebody tosses a coin. And before tossing it, they call heads or tails. And they toss it, and whatever comes up, you win. So if you called heads, then heads comes up, you win. And you didn't, then you're like, oh, it was tails. But so when you think about God's faithfulness, think of the head of that coin as his grace, his gift, and his goodness, the G. So the head is the G. Now, I want to tell you about the other side of the coin. The other side of the coin, the enemy, or Satan, the devil, however you refer to him, but he, if you think about the other side of the coin, using that example, he uses discouragement, depression, doubt, desire, or temptation, disaster, disarray, daunted, or you know, feeling daunted, and deception. Those are his tools.
Right.
And if you notice, I was like using all the D's, and that's, you know, for the devil, but that's the other side of the coin. So when you're faced with you know, one of those things, you're looking at one side of the coin. And so, and using the example that I spoke about at the women's conference, I had doubt. I had, you know, even though I was looking at the, when we first started, I was like, oh, yay, heads, you know, it's, oh, it's gifts and grace and goodness. And then, but when I got there and I was sitting in the chair listening to everybody, I started thinking about doubt. How could we perform in front of all these people? And then I got discouraged. And then there was a little bit of disarray that we won't talk about because we got over it. There was just a little bit. And, but once we started, I received a gift, and the gift was in the form of his presence. All those people at the altar, that was a gift. And I was so thankful, I really was, for that gift. I felt, at the conference, we felt the Holy Spirit, but it wasn't until that moment that I felt the presence of God. And I was so thankful. And even though it was all that, our mother was standing there just as happy. Oh, yay, baby. Yay, baby. So I felt her love. But it's different feeling my mother's love and feeling God's love.
Yes.
But the using that, so that's an example about me, but I'm thinking about an example from the Bible. I think about, again, it's Youth Sunday, and that's why we're all wearing denim. And I was thinking about a story that all the children could relate to. And in Sunday school, children are taught about the story of David and Goliath. And so that was a relatable story. And I thought about when David, when he approached Goliath and he had those five smooth stones, that I wondered if he was thinking about any of the D's, if he was thinking discouraged, if he was feeling doubt, if he was feeling daunted. But if he was, he managed to take one of those stones and kill him in one shot. So he was able to take what the enemy had for him and to use it for the betterment. So I tend to feel like he felt like he was being stretched and he came, but, you know, maybe that's just me being in the audience, maybe, you know, being there or feeling that, but I think he might have felt like he was being stretched. Okay, so in saying that, I would like for each of you to think about.
Can you get Devil's cards?
other things. I would like each of you to think about, each person to take two of those cards, two of the index cards, and think about some of the G's that I listed about, God's goodness and His grace, and then think about some of the D's. And on one card, list out your G's, and on the other side, or on the other card, list out the D's. It doesn't have to be long or major or in depth, but I didn't get a chance to fill out my card because I was doing a lot this morning, but I can tell you what my card will have on it if somebody can give me two cards, I'll fill one out or fill two out. But with mine, I thought about my birth. I was born prematurely, and I was less than 5 pounds. I don't know how much did I weigh? 3 pounds. She's holding 3 fingers, so I was 3 pounds when I was born. And, Tristan was less than 2 pounds, but this is now. We're talking about in 1971. So I was 3 pounds, and I was in an incubator, and I was born to teenage parents. But I was born, and I was born into an amazingly loving family. So that's grace. That's great. So I would list that. I would also list my I was born into an amazing family, and my husband, I would list him and our children as the heads, some of the G things on the list. Because I'm so thankful for them and for what they give me. Another example I would list would be my church family. I'm so grateful to our church parents, pastors. I'm thankful and grateful to my brothers and sisters here. I love all of you. So I now have an extended family, so I'm thankful for that. So that would go on the G side of the card. But in writing that out, I want you to remind yourselves of how grateful, how of all the good things that you have.
Yes.
An example on the other card, I would list my job. Sometimes the workload is daunting and discouraging, and I would list that. I'm thankful for my job and I love my job, but sometimes it's stressful. One of the other things I would list would be health, that we've had some recent health attacks and issues, and Joshua Stubb just told us last night, and he's supposed to be doing the offering, and I worry. Mom has been under attack, and I worry about my immediate family, my extended family, and my church family, so I would list that. And what else did I say was wrong with this? I don't know, I guess I should have done it ahead of time. But once everyone has listed everything, then what I want you to do with the card that has all the D things on it, I want to collect them, or I want you to come and lay them at the altar. I want to teach our children to give all of those things to God. So I want this to be an exercise in them laying it down and giving it to God. And if they're not comfortable with coming up and laying it down and giving it to God, and just come give me a hug, and you know how when you go somewhere and your mother tries to slip your money and she folds it up and she hands it in your hand, so just give it to me in my hand and I'll put it at the altar for you, or give it to one of the ushers and they'll put it at the altar for you. But as you and then I want opportunity to play Great Is Thy Faithfulness, but as she's playing that and we are laying our stuff at the altar, I want you to remember these things about God's faithfulness.
Yes.
And I've listed them. June, could you put up that list for me, please? Mm-hmm. The list of the scriptures. Because I did want to give you some scripture, but so I'm going to put it up on the screen and you can look at it. And okay. So the things I want you to remember is that he's faithful when we're not. And 2 Timothy 2:13 says, if we are faithless, he remains faithful. The second thing I would like you to remember is that he is as faithful today as he was yesterday.
Yes.
And Psalm 111:7-8 say that the works of his hands are faithful and just.
Yes.
All of his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever.
Yes.
To be performed with the faithfulness and uprightness. The next thing I want you to remember is that his word is eternal. And that's referenced in Psalm 119:89. Forever, O Lord, is your word firmly fixed in the heavens. And the last thing I want you to remember about his faithfulness is we can depend on his faithfulness.
Yes.
And in Exodus 34:6, it says, the Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God, merciful and gracious, slow to anger, is abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. And also remember that I love each and every one of you, but more importantly, God loves you. And it is because of his love that each of you are entitled and empowered to his great and unlimited faithfulness.
Faithfulness.
Sometimes it was hard to get that out, but he remains faithful. I'm a witness. He remains faithful to us. What a wonderful, wonderful message we have from her today for the youth. To know, to learn now about God's faithfulness. Oh, we can tell you about a lot of things when they said to Pastor, says, you dodged a bullet. We said, oh no, we didn't dodge no bullet. Thank you, Jesus. We did not dodge a bullet because God is faithful. And he knew he had a lot planned for my husband. Just good to see you all here. We do have some cookies and some refreshment downstairs. Anytime youth, we have to eat. So we would like for you to come down and partake of some of the cookies and a little bit of muffins. And we just want to bless you today and thank God for your presence. And that as you go through the week, you will sense his faithfulness. Sense his faithfulness. I just so much appreciate Kevin. Kevin tries to make it every Sunday. Sometimes he doesn't, but more times he does. And he's faithful of bringing someone from his job. How else would they know about Jesus? And how much would they know about Kevin? Except he brings them here to learn about the faithfulness of God. God's faithfulness. Oh, Monica, what a wonderful, wonderful message. Wonderful message. Thank you so much. Good to see our son Lawrence here this morning. Oh, my lads, I was just thinking about you. We are doing some premarital counseling for a couple, and I was trying to get you to go on their trip to the islands. That's where they're getting married at. And they needed a photographer. I said, oh, I got one for you. His name is Lawrence. They said, oh, we have to use the photographer of the hotel where they are. See, I didn't know, but I was trying to get you to the islands. Praise God, praise God. He's awesome. He is awesome. And so since Monica ministered this morning the word, we're glad to have her uncle here, her mother and father, her brother, her nieces, her children, and everybody else that loves you. They're here to support you. And this isn't your only time, dear. No. It is not your only time.
I'm sorry. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. And so we are going to ask her husband. We're going to let this be a family affair. If he would dismiss us this morning. And oh, yes, we're glad to see. Where did she go? Oh, there she is, Deb. Deb is going to be part of our team for self-defense, so we're glad to see her here this morning, praise God. And our son Horace, he sneaks out as much as he can. Love you, son, love you. Oh, I just love all of you. And we got Will back out again and his family, praise God. Got such a beautiful wife and family, such a beautiful wife, praise God. And most of all, I'm glad to see family life here today. Glad to see all of you, praise God. Okay, our son Russell, take us out.
My. Stand to your feet if you would. Great is thy faithfulness. God is a faithful God. But we have a command as well. If we be faithful over a few things, he'll make us rule over many. So if you expect God's faithfulness in your life, do your part. I thank and praise God for my beautiful wife and the lovely message that we received today. I applaud you. I thank God for all that have come out in support of her. My friend Deb, my friends Will, Trina, Tim, and Isaiah. And Will, brother, I know I haven't really took time out and said to you what a blessing you are. You and your family. Wonderful wife, wonderful young man. It's a blessing. And he's a mighty worker when it comes to God's man. He will take you from the guttermost to the uttermost. Generally has Bible study for men on Tuesday nights. If you need more information, please see me. So I'll keep in touch with him. I enjoy it. Horace went to the last one and Will thought that he took his lesson plan over. And it was good to know that I already knew as well that Horace said, well, all I did was take and say some of the things that mom and pops teach us here at Family Life. So it's a blessing. It really is. So if all hearts and minds are clear, can we look to the Lord? Lord God, our Father, we thank you once and again for blessing us to be in your service and to, Lord God, hear a word from you, that great is thy faithfulness. Lord God, we thank you for how your mercies are renewed each and every day. Lord God, as we go forward from this place, but not from your presence, we'd ask that you go before us, make our ways safe and clear, bless and protect each and every one of us. Oh, Lord God, we thank you for this and for all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.